Let's continue our discussion about the theoretical and practical issues and their significance for L2 writing. So we will discuss theory and its implications for composition. ESL here stands for English as Second Language. There is a range of studies which have seen writing from different angles. So remember, we don't have a clear-cut theory which explicitly tells researchers how to teach writing. So what I mean to say is there is no tidy or clean corpus of conclusive theory which clearly indicates how to teach writing effectively. We have situational syllabus, topical syllabus within process-based approaches. But what I mean to say is the concept of single framework for teaching writing is a long way off. It has a long way to see. So the lack of conclusive theory within teaching writing paradigm has generated a number of theories, a number of notions. So this is how, which starting from behaviorism to cognitivism to interactionism and socioculturalism, academic literacies, communities of practice. So I can list a number of theories which help us understand how students learn to write and how teaching actually helps them write effectively. So the question is how to help students write effectively in a speedy manner, in an effective manner. So this has emerged as a discipline, and we have seen a number of debates covering L2 composition. So 1960s saw the emergence of L1 rhetoric, that L1 has its own, its influences in number of ways on L2 writers in terms of comprehension, in terms of composition. And this era, 1960s, saw the use of literature in language classes, canonical literature in language classes. So what the students would do, they would read literature and they would analyze it, appreciate it, and write the composition produced on the themes found within the literature. And from our own historical perspective, I have seen, especially when we had traditional bachelors of arts programs, we had short stories, paper A, and we had in paper B composition and writing. So this was very much vogue in 1960s, and in that time there was no time given to allocated to planning, drafting, editing, sharing, revising, self-editing. These elements come within the purview of process approach. So what traditional approaches saw, they would make students learn an array of school-based genres. For example, how to appreciate poetry, how to appreciate short story, how to appreciate fiction. So that the purpose was to make the student write, but these were not found effective one. And then the conventional model was, because of its limitations, it was rejected, and because it made the students write compositions within the rigid rules, established rules of grammar. So students were not taught the strategies of writing. Strategies, I mean to say, like how to brainstorm, how to come up with ideas, how to write the first draft, how to write the second draft, how to revise it in the face of the feedback, in the light of the feedback. Then 1980s, with the coming of communicative approach, with the coming of sociocultural theory, we saw the emergence of process approaches. But these approaches were not without their limitations, because they didn't focus on the sociocultural contexts within which writing took place. Then we saw academic literacies, and that actually laid emphasis on seeing writing as a situated learning within its sociocultural context. So in this regard, it's important to see how teachers believe about writing, how they see writing, and how they see teaching styles and classroom contexts. So even these paradigms had their own limitations in terms of on the basis of ideological, social, cultural, and ethical grounds. Now we have this Lev and Wenger's, which is communities of practice, that expert writers should make spaces for novice writers. So this is how theory in ESL composition has given different insights at different stages to the teachers to see their teaching practice and to make it much more efficient and effective.